What's up, freaks? It's Steve from Peak Physique Personal Training Bootcamp and Boxing. This is Steve Says, episode number 66. Holy crap, 66 episodes in. You know about Steve Says, some people will hate, but most can relate. That's what it's all about. And I can't believe I'm going to talk about it. I'm going to talk about the L word. We're going to get to that in a second. And we're going to talk about how this L word has disappeared from the world. It's going to be crazy. But you know, Steve says some people hate, but most can relate. Steve says each week is a live show on how to have a no excuses, badass mindset, guiding you to adapt, overcome, destroy the obstacles, preventing success in your health, your family, your finances, so you can stop being a little bitch, get your shit together, and live life on your own fucking terms. That's what it's all about. And this week, again, we're going to talk about the L word. I'm pulling you up on the screen here. If you need some advice about the L word, oh man, I can't believe I'm doing this. I can't believe it. This is crazy. So I'm going to pull you up on here, refresh that screen. If you have any questions, comments, or you need any help, developing the L word, Steve is here to help you. We're going to talk about it. Never thought you'd get advice on the L word from me, huh? Bet you never thought that. Sound check, we're all good. Perfect. So if you have any questions, comments, I have you down there on the second screen. Let's talk about it. So this week, where has the L word gone in this world? Why has it disappeared from the world? Why has it become so rare in the world? The L word has disappeared. Where has it gone? Yes, giving advice. You know you're fucked up if you need to come to Steve Says get advice on the L word. But you should. Stay tuned. We're going to get to that in a second. So how do we get it back? How do we get it? Why did we lose it? How do we get it back? And, you know, this is what we're going to talk about. We're going to get into the details of this. I can't believe that I'm doing this. It's just missing in the world. It's missing in society that I needed to do it. I had no choice. I have no choice but to do this. But we know Steve Says is about becoming a better version of yourself every day, getting your shit together, stop being a little bitch, trusting the process, not making any freaking excuses. We know the invasion is coming, so we need to be ready for this L word because it's gone. It's missing, and I can't go on anymore without expressing my feelings about this L word. I can't do it. I can't go on another minute. I had to do this. Whether or not it kills my reputation, I don't care, but I have to do it. And yes, I'm going to be giving you advice on the L word, how to find this feeling back in your life, how to fulfill your life with this L word. I don't know if I could even say it. I don't know if I could even say the word because it hurts me so much that it's missing from the world. And I see it every day, missing from the world, from people around you. And the word is loyalty, because if you fucking thought I was talking about anything else, you got to be out of your fucking mind. I don't know what you thought I was going to talk about, but we're talking about fucking loyalty. It's missing from the freaking world. It's gone. It's been disappeared. And yes, loyalty is a feeling. It's not just a word. It's a fucking feeling, and it's the important feeling you can have in the world, and it's fucking missing from society. It's missing from the fucking world. There's just nastiness all over the place. So what is loyalty? What is loyalty? Loyalty is the state or the quality of being loyal, faithfulness to commitments or obligations, adherence to I'm not going to say government because we don't give a fuck about that, but adherence to a cause or a leader or a person or faithful to a state of thought. It's commitments and obligations to a cause, a person, a thing, a leader, a party. Loyalty, and it's fucking missing. And it's an allegiance. It's adhering to something. Honor. How about that? These are all fall under fucking loyalty, and it's gone. It's not, you don't see it out there. One out of 99 is fucking out there, or whatever the fuck. One out of 100. 99 out of 100 is not there with the L word. They're missing the fucking L word. And it's devotion and integrity and dependability. All this can fall under the L word. All of it's the same thing. It falls in there. Reliability, support, devoted, steadfast. How about that shit? And just trustworthiness. That's the other definitions of loyalty. And it's not out there. It's not out there in the fucking world anymore. It's gone. Yes, lunch, but it said L-O. Lunch. Lunch is missing too in society. It really upsets me that lunch is not in fucking society. But loyalty is not there. They're just some slimy, backstabbing motherfuckers all over the world, right in your own world, on your own block, in your own fucking job, probably, in your own fucking household, probably. So what's the Steve Says definition of loyalty? What is the Steve Says definition? Because I gave you all those proper, devoted, and sincerity, and reliability. All good words. All definitely are loyal, or are considered the same as loyalty. And allegiance. I like that one. Allegiance. Allegiance. How many people around you can you say there's an allegiance? Can you say that about the people around you? Those motherfuckers down the block? The people that you've helped? The people that you've gone out of your way for and helped them? You create things for them? You maybe gave them opportunities? Maybe sacrificed your own shit for other people? For them just to give you a big old fuck you afterwards, right? That's called... And you didn't do it because you want anything in return. You didn't do it because you want anyone to know about it. But the least that someone could do is be fucking loyal. How about that? When you risk your own ass for someone else, you take a loss for someone else, take blame for someone else, give someone else opportunity, give someone else a chance, give someone else a second, third, fourth, fucking hundredth chance to only be fucking spit on and stabbed in the back. So the Steve Says definition of loyalty is very simple. Don't be a fucking douchebag. It's as simple as that. Don't be a fake, slimy, backstabbing motherfucker. How about that? That's a good... That should be in the dictionary. I'm going to write my own dictionary. It's going to be the Steve Says dictionary, and it's going to be awesome. I should actually do that. That's a great idea. The Marine Corps motto, always faithful. Semper Fidelis, which is always faithful. Always faithful. Basically, it's just loyalty. And the saying of once a Marine, always a Marine. Why can't that be the thought in society? Once a Marine, always a Marine. Basically, you're that person that reached out their hand and fucking sacrificed and maybe almost died for you. You're going to be loyal to them all the time, no matter what. But why can't it be like that in the real world? Why can't we be more like a freaking Marine? And you can't become a Marine without having loyalty. First, of course, for the country, for each other, for the other Marines, for the people you don't even know, for people to just be free. And that's where Semper Fidelis, always faithful, comes from. Basically, that's loyalty. That is loyalty. That's like the highest feeling you could have when it comes to this kind of stuff. And that's what always faithful represents. The loyalty to the person on your left, the person on your right, in front of you, behind you, the motherfuckers you never met, the people who on paper probably don't even deserve it. But guess what? You're going to still give them loyalty because that's just the motherfucking kind of person you are. You're going to still give it to them. Even though they maybe don't, it doesn't seem like they deserve it. And they're going to stab you in the back anyway. Guess what? We'll still probably reach our hand out to them. Because that's what's called loyalty is. And in the Marine Corps, loyalty is being devoted, of course, to your country, to the Marine Corps, to your superiors, to your peers, to your subordinates. That's what loyalty is. Loyalty in all different directions. Not when it suits you, when it's going to fucking help you get ahead or something. It's an unwavering loyalty. Is just unwavering. It doesn't matter what direction you're freaking in. And in your chain of command, since we're talking about military, up and down your chain of command. Loyalty up and down and sideways in your chain of command. How about your chain of command in fucking life? How about to the left and to the right and in front and behind you in life? Where's the loyalty there? Where's the loyalty out there in society? Like, and with when it comes to leadership, a leader, same way out in the Marine Corps, needs to be, you're the leader of the family, you're the leader of your office, you're the leader of your team, whatever it is, of your group, of your circle, of your sector. And you need to have the loyalty to, again, to your peers, to maybe the people, I don't want to say above you, but if your boss or whatever you want to call it, your leader, even though you are a leader, your leader, or the people you lead, loyalty in every fucking direction, 365 degrees, unwavering loyalty. Unwavering loyalty. Where is that in the world? It's lacking. It's fucking lacking. And that's why I was dead serious when I said about this, that it fucking hurts me to see the L word missing in the world. Because I've been stabbed in the back fucking millions of times. I'm still here. I got thick skin. It just builds my fucking battlefield armor, my life armor. So I love it. I could deal with it. But where is it? It does still fucking hurt me to see the lack of loyalty, the lack of the fucking L word out in the world. And it goes in all different directions, in all areas of life. It's just the way it needs to be. And loyalty is not when it fits you or when it suits you or for you to benefit. Loyalty is it's not even tangible. That's why I say it is a feeling. It is a feeling. Like the L word you thought I was gonna say. You couldn't have really thought. I saw some names pop on this live and they're already gone probably. That were watching this when I first popped on. They're like, no way. I gotta see this. They're already gone, but whatever. Anyway, loyalty is loyal to your principles. Loyalty, and it shouldn't be confused with just being blind and naive and stupid and loyal to, like, say, I don't know, whatever, a drug dealer or something. You know what I mean? That's not loyalty. That's just fucking stupid and ignorant. We're not talking about that. We're talking about with some common sense, with good, with discipline and good morals and ethics or whatever. And you need to be loyal to your fucking mission, to your vision, to the direction you're going in your freaking life. That's loyalty. And people are not. They'll jump and one day they, how could one day this be the shit and the best? But the next way, this is the shit and this is the best. And now you suck. How could that be? How could that be unless you are a fake motherfucker? How could that be? And you see it all the fucking time, like every day. And it's, I try not to go on Facebook too much just to see some of our peak freaks, see what's going on in our different groups and all that stuff. I try to see the basic stuff on Facebook, but you can't avoid it. It sucks you in and you start scrolling and you get into that death scroll and you just see the fucking stupidity that's out there, the ignorance that's out there. And it's crazy. So, you know who's the most loyal? You know who's loyal and it's who we should emulate more? We should be more like fucking dogs. Like this dog right here, like Tyson. He was the most loyal thing in the freaking world. Do you know, one time I was in the woods and there was a bear. It had to be at least like 300 pounds. I almost shit my fucking pants. Because what are you going to do against a bear? Tyson fucking charged after that bear. And the bear was like, holy fuck. The bear took off. And Tyson kept chasing it. Like wanted to hunt this bear down. Not because he just wanted to get in a fight. Not because he wanted to eat him. He wasn't hungry. He's not going to eat a fucking bear. It was just his loyalty to me. Like he was going to die chasing that fucking huge ass bear. And just because he saw that I'm, and he could feel it like I'm, oh, fuck. He probably smelled the shit in my pants, but that's besides the point. He probably smelled the shit in my pants, so he went after that bear in protective mode. That's fucking loyalty. Like, willing to die for it. That's loyalty. Maybe he just pissed me off and I just smacked him in the ass 2 seconds later because I left him in the car for a second and he ate my turkey sandwich, and I smacked him in the ass and was so pissed at him, yelling at him. Smacked him in the ass. 2 seconds later, this fucker is ready to die. He's ready to die chasing a bear. This is a true fucking story with the turkey sandwich and all. Just finished smacking his ass, screaming at him because I was starving. I needed to replenish after my workout. I need some protein. He ate my whole fucking turkey sandwich. Smacked his ass, screamed at him. He was all in the back seat, all disappointed in himself, all pissed off. This was like 10, 12 years ago. But this little dog, 60 pounds, saw me, smelt me shit my pants, and chased after a fucking bear. Did not even think. Didn't flinch. Didn't consider, like, should we run? What should we do? It's just like, bam! And the bear said, fuck, I'm out. The bear is gone. That dog, Tyson, was fucking, that's loyalty. Not zero fear when it comes to the who you're loyal to, who you have an allegiance to, a bond with, like just ready to fucking die. The same thing happened to a deer one time. He actually caught the deer because the deer ran into a corner that was a fence and Tyson actually speared the deer and tackled it, knocked it up against a fence. Then the deer ran up and got away. The deer was actually fast. Tyson was fast, but that deer was fucking fast. But that's a different story. That's loyalty. That is dedication. That's fucking like you don't get any more loyalty to that. That's why he's on our logo. That's why he was our mascot in the gym. That's like the definition of loyalty. And that's why I'm using it as a logo. People are like, why do you have a fucking dog on your thing? Are you a dog trainer? People have actually talked to me years ago when I was in a park throwing the ball to Tyson. He'd be running and get it. Tyson the dog, not the boy. The boy wasn't even here yet 10, 12 years ago. Throwing the ball for Tyson in the park, he would run and get it, bring it back, put it down my feet, throw it again. He would just do whatever. He never owned a leash. He would just was well trained, more trained than most humans. Definitely more loyal than 99.99999% of motherfucking humans. But people would come up to me because they would see all the stickers on my car back then and would ask if I'm a dog trainer because they see a dog on the logo. They see me with a well-trained dog. They see the shit on my car training. They thought I was a dog trainer. But I don't even remember what the point that was. But they thought I was a dog trainer. And that, oh, why he's on the logo. So people are like, why do you have a fucking dog on your logo? You're a gym. That doesn't even make sense. You know why? Because in order for you to get anywhere successful in life, first of all, like this fucking pit bull on my chest, he was willing to die for the cause. He was willing to die for the fucking mission accomplishment. He was willing to die for his allegiance to his group, to his sector, willing to die for it. He was willing to take his fucking jaws and latch it onto something and not let go till he got what he needed to get, till he accomplished his mission. He's not going to let go of his goals until he's successful or fucking dies. That's why he's on this. That's why he's on our logo. And that's what you need to do for your weight loss, for your success, for whatever other fucked up shit going on in your head. Are you willing to die? Are you loyal? That's loyalty. Ready to fucking die for the cause. Die for the mission. Die for your people. Die for your group who you have an allegiance to, for the ones who look out for you, who go out of their way for you, instead of just stabbing in the back like those slimy motherfuckers we were talking about. That's why he's on there. So you need to be more like a dog. You need to be more like a Marine. Actually, that's funny. We just watched a movie a little while ago called Max about a Marine dog. You need to be like a fucking Marine dog. It doesn't get any more loyal than that. The best of the Marine, a dog. Bam, he doesn't get any more loyal than that. You'd be like a fucking Marine dog as you used to be. Moral of the story, don't be a fucking scumbag. Don't be a douchebag. Too many people are going lame nowadays. Too many people are going lame for I don't even know what reasons. Lameness everywhere. Going lame. Psst. Turning their backs on people who fucking basically help them survive and help them live and help them thrive. Too many people are going lame. Don't drown the fucking person that taught you how to swim. Don't bite the hand that feeds you, since we're talking about dogs. If this was the old days, the way Facebook, it goes back to Facebook and social media. Of course we're on Facebook, and it has its uses, obviously. We like it. We communicate. I can communicate with you freaks. But the old days of Facebook, the old days, the way that people act on Facebook, you act like that in the old days, act like that a few hundred years ago, you would not survive. Your lack of loyalty and your fucking public scumbaggedness, when you would get fucking hunted down with an axe on a fucking horse. I put a post the other day, I don't even remember what, something about people getting punched in the face, that Facebook gives the people, like, they just hide behind their Facebook and all that shit. If this was a couple hundred years ago, you'd fucking probably be dead. No one would have put up with that shit. That's the way that shit was done. You're not loyal? That's like a fucking cardinal sin. You wouldn't survive the old days, these Facebook motherfuckers. Be loyal to your mission. Be loyal to your people. Be loyal to your mentors. Be loyal to the people who helped you out. Be loyal to the people who uplifted you and brought you up. Be loyal to them. Be loyal to your fucking self. Hold yourself accountable. Of course, make no fucking excuses. Be like the pit bull on my fucking chest, ready to die for the fucking mission. Ready to die for it. That's loyalty. Stop being a fucking scumbag. Be loyal like a Marine. Be loyal like a dog. Be loyal like a fucking pit bull. Latch your jaws onto success, onto your goals, onto your dreams, and don't fucking let go. Because you need to be loyal if you want to be successful. You need to be loyal if you want to hit your goals. And when you do, after you do, don't drown that person that helped you fucking get there. That's just some scumbag shit. Be loyal. Dog. Marine. Fucking pit bull. Because you are fucking awesome. I will talk to you later. No excuses.